now for something completely different. So you might see on the program it says Sloop John B. And if you are, you know, thinking about maybe some 60s rock and you think about the Beach Boys, right? And there's a song. All right. This is based on the same folk song, but it's a totally different arrangement. Don't expect me to be singing a bunch of harmonies in front of this group for you. So we're going to get going with this. Hope you enjoy it. Sloop John B.
Next on our program is he's called March to the Scaffold. And contrary to what you might think, this is not a protest at a construction site. There's a different meaning for the word scaffold, and that's the structure that supports a guillotine. And so we're going to take a little bit of a dark turn in the program. But dark, but kind of humorous turn to the program. So the lines between reality and fantasy and imagination are kind of blurred in this piece. I'm not even sure I totally understand. It's pretty convoluted, but okay, so you're in for a story. So the composer Hector Berlioz had a passion for the arts from a young age and for music, but his father really didn't want him to pursue that. So his father said, well, you're going to go to medical school. And so that's exactly what he did. So after completing medical school, he very rebelliously went and pursued arts and literature. And at one point in, I think this was maybe 1800 sometime, 1827 or something, he went to see a Shakespeare play, he went to see Hamlet. And he fell in love with one of the actresses in Hamlet. And but she was really having none of it. She didn't want to have much to do with him in spite of him coming to shows all the time and writing her love letters. And she was not into that at all. And he became more and more obsessed. And then after about 3 years of this unreturned interest, he wrote a piece of music about it. And the piece of music, in this piece of music, it's a semi-autographical piece of music. Like I said, this is where the lines between fantasy and reality kind of become blurred. So in this piece of music, he takes an overdose of opium. And then he has these dreams while he's under the influence of opium. And he dreams about his beloved, and there's a theme that comes out through the piece, that comes throughout the piece over and over, recurring theme that represents his beloved. And so the first few movements of this piece are just various other stories about him and his love for her. But then the fourth movement, which is March to the Scaffold, this takes a very dark turn. Because he has killed her. And so so he is being put on trial, and so he's being marched to the scaffold. And so he has punishment for his crime. And this is where it's very, very dark, but very humorous. And I'm wondering if maybe the band could show a little bit about what's, just so you know what's happening as it happens. So it's good. The beginning is, there's a long progression of this march to the scaffold. It's very, very dark, very very ominous. And then, at one point, out of nowhere, the theme returns. And this is his last thought of his beloved. Isn't that nice? Okay, so that's his beloved, and that's his last thought. And then, well, we'll play it first, and then we'll tell you what it is. That was, like I said, his last thought was just prior to this meter, and what's happening there is the first note is, it's his head getting severed, chopped off. Okay. And the next three beats is his head bouncing down the steps of the platform. So that's what's going on. It's kind of somber. I don't know why any of you are laughing. This is kind of serious. But but something else happens then. The crowd is glad to see him go. Okay. This is the crowd cheering. Thinks about his love, and he chops his head off, rolls down the steps, and then the crowd starts cheering. So that's what happens in this piece. This is one of my favorite pieces ever. Okay, now, this is, it does have a happy ending, kind of. It has a happy next chapter, because what happens is, a few years later, this girl that he was obsessed with in real life went to see this piece performed, and she kind of dug it, and they ended up getting married. But like I said, not a totally happy ending, because then they got divorced within a decade. So it didn't end up all good, but that's the story of March to the Scaffold. I hope you enjoy it.
Thank you.
We have one more selection for you before we turn this over to the community choir. The song is called The Genesis. And this is inspiration, believe it or not. It doesn't make any noise unless you get really close. And I just happened to come across this actually earlier this year after I had chosen this piece for a group. As I was going through some of my stepfather's things, volcanic ash from June 13th, 1980 eruption of Mount St. Helens. And that's what we got right here, is some of that ash. If you were around at that time, you might remember, it kind of covered a lot of stuff. If you weren't around at that time, this was a huge event. And that's what Regenesis is about. It's about the time that worked up to the eruption of the volcano, and then what happened to the ground and the area after the volcano with the eruption. So there's four main sections, and hopefully you can kind of hear, imagine thinking about leading up. There's the warning, there's the actual cataclysm, there's, in the end, the regenesis of the land. So I'm going to leave our inspiration right here, just in case it helps you think about it. All right, and here's the regenesis.
Thank you. We'll give a moment for the band to get resituated and have a seat out there and join you in the audience as our choir members begin to clean up on stage. And some of our band people are just gonna step on over to the other side. So, if you've played a band instrument in your life, ever, you know, say you played through high school and you know you just never followed up through it on college, that's great, come join us. We'll have fun reuniting you with your instrument and reuniting you with music to enjoy and play with us here on stage. Also, singing. Most of you can probably do it. And we'd love to hear your voices. And you know what? Maybe if you're shaking your head at me, I bet you've got a neighbor who can sing. And invite them. Say, hey, you ought to go up to the college in the fall and try out for that whole community education music choir and band thing. Yeah, it'll be a good deal. So we hope to see more folks join us on stage. You know, I talked about this a year ago, and we grew. And I talked about this in December, and we grew. So help us grow some more. Are we all here? One, two, they look like they're here.
Right.
It's time for our lightheartedness to take a dark turn. Not quite like Berlioz, but this next song is a lullaby from a musical entitled Sweeney Todd. Now, there's a movie that came out a few years ago about this musical. How many people know anything about Sweeney Todd? The demon barber of Fleet Street. Yeah, so... okay. Yeah, so the basic story is that this man's a barber, had a wonderful wife. One of the local government officials in town really wanted to have his wife as his own, and so sent the barber to jail, well, in Australia. The barber serves his time, comes back home, meets up with a lady who sells meat pies at a shop. And that's a whole other story. And a whole other gruesome song. They have a young lad who joins them, and they sell meat pies together. And the young lad joins them, and he sort of falls in love, kind of as an orphanish mother figure thing to the woman, Mrs. Lovett, who sells the meat pies. And this is a little lullaby between the two, except that the youth has figured out that maybe that Sweeney Todd guy and the recent mass disappearance of many people and the increase in sales of meat pies are somehow tied together. So, so this lullaby is a little bit dark.
Charm you with a smile for a while, but in time, nothing can harm you.
Likeness of Shakespeare there for us. This next song, also from a musical entitled Pippin, has to do with a lot of magic going on, and the particular individual we're looking at here was just looking for a place to be himself.
Thank you.
I'd once again like to thank Paula Arnold for enduring me. Thank you, Paula. Oh, look at this. Look at this. Oh. This is heavy. It's heavy duty. Thank you. And thank you.
Paula, too.
Paula, too? Oh. That's nice. Have a wonderful rest of your week, folks.